Look who it is, star of the new film, Rampage.
Good to see you, buddy.
Dwayne The Rock Johnson, how are we?
Good, how are we? We are good.
You good?
I'm good, man. Good to see you again.
Before we stop, I've heard you've got a routine, right, which happens every single day, no matter where you're on the world. Is this true?
It is.
Talk me through it.
I'll get up and, let's see. I'll get up, brush my teeth.
Sure.
Got to do that. Meditate.
Oh, really? Huh? For how long?
Anywhere between. Well, it all depends on how much time I have, you know. 20, 30 minutes sometimes. Sometimes 15. Sometimes 10.
Okay.
You know.
Busy day.
Yeah, busy day. But yeah, I got to do that. And then once I do that, then I get into my breakfast. And then I go train. And then after I train, I come back. I shower. Get a little work done. No, after I meditate, I got to get my work done. This means work on the computer. Yes, this is what that means.
Surely you've got someone to do that for you. You're not doing
do
that.
Do this. And then I go to work after.
Perfect.
Yeah.
And you work on films like this, which, by the way, this is an intense film.
It was very intense. Yeah, it was an intense film because, you know, the process, we had three gigantic monsters and we're running around. I mean, it was obviously a big popcorn movie and we wanted to have fun with it, but it was... Also, I mean, these monsters are just kicking the shit out of me and my best friend George, and we're just getting thrown around and tossed around and just get my ass kicked. So it was pretty intense.
I don't want to give too much from the film away, but my favorite bit was the plane bit.
Yeah, that was an amazing sequence, man. It was crazy.
How was it? Because you end up kind of skydiving at that bit. How did that whole thing happen?
We were on a soundstage and they built the shell of this big C-17.
Yeah.
And inside it rotates and it's on a gimbal. Okay. So it rotates up, down, sideways, upside down. You're on wires and you're getting thrown everywhere. I mean, that was a really long, intense sequence because
heavy.
The plane's going down. Yeah, and it's heavy.
How do you find working with so much green screen in films like this? Are you just kind of used to it now that it feels normal?
No, I'm used to it, but it's a certain muscle that you got to exercise, and if you're not used to it, it takes a little bit of time. Like Naomi Harris's character, she wasn't used to it, so it took her a little bit of time to get used to it. But once you get used to it, it's, you know, it is what it is.
It's there. Straight
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
And I was stalking your Twitter before, because you're very good at Twitter.
Thank you very
much.
Which
I like.
Thank you.
And you follow Rotten Tomatoes.
I do,
the
yes.
The review people.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Do you read my reviews?
I do, yes. It's so funny. You know, we woke up today and we kind of had breakfast. We went to go work out and then I started reading reviews. But, and we're actually laughing today at how I read reviews. Because, you know, because you can't, I think when you make movies, right, a critic has a job, and the job is to find out the wrong shit with the movie.
Sure.
That's a hard job, man. Like, it's hard, but it's also a tough place to be in because you got to go into a movie looking for the problems and what you don't like. So inherently, it's already an energetic, kind of messed up place.
Yeah.
But a job is a job, and I get it. We all have jobs, right?
And also, someone else you follow is, I'm a massive fan of them, is Conor McGregor.
Oh, yeah,
yes.
Yeah, he's my buddy, man.
And he's come from a kind of a similar world where you started. Do you think he could make that transition into acting if he wanted to?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, he absolutely could. You know, because he has a presence. Conor not only has a presence about him, and, you know, you could go to acting school, and a lot of people try, but, you know, the presence is something that you're kind of blessed with.
Yeah.
And he's blessed with that, but he's also... he's also blessed as an incredible showman, and he's an incredible promoter. So, I like him a lot, man. He's my guy. Because, look, by the way, he's so polarizing, which makes him great. But at the end of the day, when you strip all that shit away, right, he's a promoter, he's a businessman, he's a champion, he's the best on the planet at what he does in MMA. But when you strip it all away, it all comes down to the hard work you put in.
Yeah.
Like every day, it all comes down to the hard work.
And question, right?
Got it.
Just between me and you.
I got it. Just between us. The cameras aren't on.
Forget about it.
Yeah.
Man on man. Shirts off.
Shirts off.
Greasy. I don't know why I said greasy.
I don't know why. It's okay. Now I'm still there. Go ahead.
Who's winning between you and Conor McGregor? I think you.
If our shirts are off, it's greasy.
Yeah, it's greasy.
Well, what are the rules, though? By the way, if the rules are, if we're in an octagon.
It's an octagon.
We'll go into an octagon.
Greasy. I don't know why I keep saying greasy.
I don't know why you keep saying greasy. I don't know why you have that image in your head and you're turning red, dude. Who wins between me and Conor McGregor?
Mm.
Well, he's a showman.
Sure.
Right? I'm a showman too as well. I'd have to hook him for the rock bottom, hit him with the rock bottom.
Yeah.
Bang. Hit him with the people's elbow. Bang. Then he would kick out.
Yeah.
You know? Then he, you know.
The Rock wins. Basically, the Rock wins.
Well, Rock wins part one.
Okay.
To set up the bigger part two.
Wow. It's a money deal, baby.
Come on. We're promoters. We're promoters.
And before you go, I want to ask you some of the Google's most Googled questions about yourself.
Yeah.
Okay, just to bang through them really quickly. Is The Rock vegan?
No.
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 No, no. But I respect the Vegs.
Yeah. Is that what you call them?
I call them the Vigs. A lot of them are friends. Yeah, I respect the Vigs.
Shout out the Vigs.
Shout out the Vigs.
What does The Rock bench? Have you got a figure?
Oh, God. I mean, probably...
4 million?
I was going to say around 12,000.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. What do you eat on a cheat day? What are you going for?
Women and pizza.
Greasy? I don't know why I'm saying this.
You love the greasy.
Sorry. What does your tattoo mean?
Oh, my tattoo means it's symbolically there's it's just it means protection, it means love, it means loyalty.
Yeah.
It's my mana, it's my spirit, both sides actually.
Okay. Two more.
Okay, go.
Would you ever return to wrestling, WWE?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
You would?
Sure.
Oh, amazing.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, Vince McMahon and I were talking probably about 2 months ago trying to figure out what I was going to do if I went back to WrestleMania. So he pitched me this really great idea that involved a tag match with, of course, Ronda Rousey, who's incredible. I'm very proud of her and Triple H and Stephanie. We're really excited about it. He and I on the phone, but...
could happen.
Well, we couldn't make it work this time because I was in Shanghai, but who knows down the line.
And before you go, last one, who would win in a thumb war between me and you?
Well, we're going to have to see, buddy. Yeah. Are we greasy?
I feel a bit greasy. 1, 2, 3, 4. I declare a thumb war. What a technique.
Cheating. 1, 2, 3. See the cheat?
You won.
See the cheat?
He's a greasy cheat.
That's a
He's
cheat.
He's a greasy
With
cheat.
With the finger.
The film is out on the 20th of April. It's called The Rampage. This is The Rock, everybody.
Buddy.